Hi guys! Welcome back to our channel. So in this video, sasabihin namin sa inyo kung paano kami nagkaroon ng free $650 by just simply opening a bank account here in Canada. So if you're interested in this topic, please continue watching! So yes guys, so we have received $650 worth of Amazon gift card by just simply opening a bank account here in Canada. Just a disclaimer guys, so this is not a sponsored video. This is just based on our experience and promos may differ depending on the banks that we are talking about. But for purposes of this video, we will talk about the bank accounts that we have opened in TD Bank or Toronto Dominion Bank here in Canada. So when we landed here in Canada, so during the first week talaga inasikaso na namin yung lahat ng dapat asikasuhin including the SIN, the health card, the SIM, and even the opening of the bank account. So Alwin and I opened accounts in TD Bank and in CIBC. Pero yung nakuha naming $650 worth of Amazon gift card ay nanggaling sa TD Bank. So, not in CIBC. So, first things first, yung $650 worth of Amazon gift card ay nakuha namin separately or putol-putol. So, first is nakatanggap ako ng $50 worth of Amazon gift card. Sunod naman, nakakuha ulit ako ng $300. So, Amazon gift card ulit yon. And pangatlo naman, nakakuha yung husband ko ng another $300 worth of Amazon gift card. So, let me run down to you kung paano ko nakuha yung mga Amazon gift cards na yon. First is, of course, nag-open muna kami ng bank account sa TD Bank. So, I will not mention na yung in-open naming account sa CIBC kasi wala kaming masyadong nakuhang promo doon. Kasi, guys, when you open a bank account here in Canada, check nyo yung mga different promos na ino-offer ng banks. So, marami yan. It just happened na malapit kami sa TD Bank kasi it's just located in Chinook Mall. Kaya yun yung kinonsider namin. And yung CIBC rin, nandun lang yun sa Chinook Mall. Pero it is the TD Bank na nakapagbigay sa amin ng $650 worth of Amazon gift card. So, para ma-check nyo rin yun, so I will discuss to you ano ba yung mga in-open naming accounts sa TD Bank. So, sa TD Bank, nag-open ako ng savings account and checking account and kumuha na rin ako ng credit card. Kasi nga guys, it's very important here na mag-build tayo ng credit score. Kaya kahit hindi ako nagki-credit card in the Philippines, I got one here. So, well, I got two kasi meron din sa CIBC. Pero sa TD Bank, I got one din para na rin makatulong sa pagbibuild ko ng credit score. And yung checking account, savings account, and even getting a credit card, ganun din yung ginawa nung husband ko. So, pareho kaming may accounts dito sa TD Bank. So, note guys, iba-iba yung tawag nila dito. Sa savings account kasi sa Philippines, diba, yun yung usually ginagamit natin for deposit, tapos dun rin tayo bumabawas kapag may mga transactions tayo. Pero dito in Canada, yung savings account is not meant for your daily use or transaction. Pag savings guys, savings talaga to, hindi mo dapat to galawin. So later on mo na yun withdrawin kapag if you are really determined na i-pull out yung savings mo. Otherwise, matcha-charge ka ng bank kasi it's really not the purpose of savings account na withdraw ka, nung withdraw from time to time. So, ano ba yung account na pwede mong galawin everyday or for your daily transactions? That is called here the checking account. So, sa Philippines, diba guys, yung checking account is meant for our checking transactions. Yung may cheque talaga tayong ginagamit. But here, Kahit checking account yung tawag, hindi kami gumagamit dito ng mga cheque para lang magamit tong account na to. So, yung checking account, yun yung account na ginagamit namin for daily transactions or kapag mag-grocery or bibili ng mga damit dyan sa Goodwill. Yun yung account na ginagamit namin or even credit card. So, sa credit card naman, we have gotten a credit limit of $1,000. So, iba rin sa ibang banks. I think merong nag-allow ng about $1,500 to $2,000. So, just ask yung bank na gusto nyo. But in the case of TD Bank, ang limit na binigay sa amin is $1,000. So, as I've mentioned earlier, nakakuha muna ako ng $50 worth of Amazon gift card dito kay TD Bank. So, bakit ba ako nabigyan ng $50 muna? So, I received $50 first worth of Amazon gift card mainly because I opened a savings account, and another factor is that I'm an international student. Kasi ako nung una din, nagtaka kasi bakit sa husband ko, walang $50 na natanggap even if nag-open rin siya ng savings account sa TD Bank. So, yun, ako lang yung nakatanggap ng $50 because ako yung nag-qualify dito sa promo nila. So, it's because of the opening of premium savings account or everyday savings account in TD Bank. So, yan, pinapakita ko sa inyo yung email na na-receive ko notifying that in order for me to get that $50 Amazon gift card, I have to accept their offer by January 31. So, na-accept ko na yan even before January 31. And after accepting their offer, na-receive ko na yung code na nilagay ko sa Amazon account ko. And yun, nag-reflect na agad na may $50 gift card ako. So, going now to the $300 worth of Amazon gift card. Actually, nauna yung husband ko makareceive nito kasi akala ko nung una hindi ako makakakomply sa conditions nila para mabigyan ng $300 worth of Amazon gift card. Ipapakita ko sa inyo yung qualifications. Paano makareceive ng $300 worth of Amazon gift card. So, these are the conditions. So, of course, o-open ng checking account yung customer, and we did that kasi nga tatlo yung in-open naming accounts, diba? And then, these are the conditions. Pero we just have to comply any two. And then, there is a deadline for us to comply these conditions. So, binigyan kami until December that time to comply. Otherwise, hindi na kami eligible for the $300 worth of Amazon gift cards. So, first is, we have to set up a recurring direct deposit from the employer or pension provider or the government. So, in my husband's case, na-meet niya to, lalong-lalo na when he started to work kasi he gave his TD Bank account as the account for the direct deposit nung employer niya sa Chinook Mall. So, dun siya babayaran directly ng salary niya sa pag-work niya. So, yan. First condition, satisfied. And then, second condition is to set up a recurring pre-authorized debit payment of at least $50. So, in this one, so dapat may iset up tayong pre-authorized debit payment sa mga bills natin here in Canada. And Alwin was able to meet this condition dahil sinet up niya for pre-authorized debit payment yung Telus Wi-Fi naman namin. And then, the third condition is to make an online bill payment of at least $50, so through Easy Web or the TD app. So, he was able to satisfy that also kasi, of course, sa dami ng bills namin dito, masasatisfy talaga tong third condition. So, yan, even if dalawa lang talaga yung required, my husband was able to satisfy all these three conditions. Actually, mga months din bago dumating tong confirmation from TD Bank na he was able to satisfy. So, hindi agad-agad na-receive to. Nag-antay talaga kami ng confirmation from the TD Bank. Yan. So, ito yung makikitang email when you satisfy the conditions of TD Bank. So, yan. This is congratulations on your new TD Unlimited checking account. And then, to thank you for completing the conditions, we'd like to give you $300 worth of Amazon gift card. So, we have to accept it also again before January 31, which we did. And then, we also received the code for the Amazon gift card information. So guys, magkasunod lang din naman namin na-receive tong Amazon gift card namin courtesy of TD Bank. And yun, we were able to use na and utilize yung unang $300 worth of Amazon gift card, especially nung holiday, di ba? So marami tayong pwedeng bilhin sa Amazon kasi hindi naman to convertible to cash since ito yung offer or promo nila talaga. So this is not convertible to cash. Although mas maganda talaga sana, no? Hindi ka mapipilitang mag-shopping through Amazon. But okay na rin kasi marami tayong mga kung ano-anong pwedeng bilhin sa Amazon. So we were able to utilize na the first 300. So meron pa kaming remaining 300 na pag-iisipan kung ano ba yung pwede naming bilhin sa Amazon. And guys, mag-itin na rin namin that when you open a bank account, whether in TD Bank or CIBC or in any other bank, it is required na meron na kayong Canadian number. So para sa mga international students na papunta pa lang dito sa Canada and would open later on a bank account here, so you can also consider already getting a Canadian SIM while still being in the Philippines. So merong exclusive offer yung FIDO. And you can already get the SIM card while still being in the Philippines. So these are the important features of the Canadian SIM card by FIDO. So now they have an upgraded data. So from 10 gigabytes, it's now 20 gigabytes of data per month. It has unlimited Canada-wide calls, whether landline or mobile, unlimited incoming calls from anywhere in the world, and unlimited local and international text messages. So the good thing here, guys, is that there is no lock-up period, meaning should you decide to cancel it or switch to another carrier, you can do so without being afraid of any penalties. And another good thing here is that the activation fee, which can be in the amount of $50, is automatically waived if you avail this exclusive offer. So with all those features, this SIM plan is only worth $40 a month. So if you're interested to get that Canadian SIM while still being in the Philippines, you can register in the link below. So that's all for this video, guys. I hope you learned something from my topic today. So if you like it, please click the thumbs up button and subscribe na rin if you have not yet subscribed. And don't forget to click the notification button in order for you to get notified of our future uploads. So thank you guys and God bless!